Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. We're outside today, and the reason we're out here is that I needed some rosemary. So I came out to the herb garden, and I thought, why not show you the herb garden as it stands today. The herb garden was planted on April the 23rd. I think I told you that at the beginning of that video. And this is June the 9th. So I'll probably be uploading this soon, but just in case I don't, you'll know that about 6 weeks have passed since the planting of this herb garden. Now I'll get my rosemary first, and unfortunately that's one of the plants that hasn't grown a whole lot, but I need a couple of sprigs about that size. So there we go on the rosemary. Right beside it I have sage. And then in the center here, we have dill. You can see on the dill that it's just shot right up and it's trying to bloom, so it's probably not going to last very long, but it's nice and healthy now, so I'm getting a lot of good use out of it. In the center here is basil. It got a slow start, but it's doing really well. I really love that, and I'm glad that we are going to have a successful year with basil. Here we have flatleaf parsley, or Italian parsley. And right beside it, I have curly parsley. I love those. Here we have our chives, and right beside it, I have cilantro, and again over here, cilantro. Now, I planted two of them because I did not have good luck last year, and the same thing is happening this year. These are trying to bolt. They're just going up into seed. You can see the stem just very quickly into seed. I try to cut the tops off and keep it making lateral growth, but that doesn't always work. Same thing happening over here with that cilantro plant. Here we have thyme, and this has had a rough time of it because it's just not growing as lushly as it usually does. This is more the look I usually get. That looks a little woody, but it's still healthy, and I think it will come out of its slump. Over here, we have oregano, and that's growing very close to the ground, so it makes it a little hard to harvest, but it's healthy, and that's the important thing. Right beside my dill, I have tarragon, and this has, there goes a butterfly, this has probably grown about 10 times what it was when it was planted, so it's doing very well. As we move on down, we have some vegetables, not many, but the three in the center here that have the tall cages are tomato plants, and there are three different varieties, so we'll have a little bit of change there from one to the other. They are blooming, and there might be a small tomato on one or two of them. Next, on these smaller cages, we have peppers. The two at the end are bell peppers. We have a red bell pepper and a green bell pepper. And in the center, I put that cage on just because I had it. Not that that plant needed it so much. That is a jalapeno pepper. And the three down here are jalapeno peppers as well. And I didn't have cages for them, but they really don't need it. So that's where we stand on the herb garden. I think it's doing really well. Over here, in the foundation planting, you might have wondered what happened with the plants that went over the winter, and I tried to save them. Well, they saved very well. Here we have thyme, which is actually quite healthy, and probably I would choose to use over the one in the herb garden until that gets healthier. Here is same thing, but it's gone to bloom and I didn't really worry about it. It's a pretty ornamental plant, but it is an herb. It's thyme again. Up here we have two oregano plants, and this one I did try to keep the blooms down, and it could be used, although I probably would use the fresher oregano in our herb garden. And this one has bloomed, and even the blooms are making seed pods up here, so it's not that good in terms of usefulness. But I wanted you to see that you can save plants over the winter, and if they come back up, you can transplant them if you don't want them in your actual herb garden. Now we're going to go over to the back of the house where I have my mint plant, and also Rick has a little garden that we're going to show you. Here at the back of our house, you can see into town, and that's a mile and a half away. That is the university. That's Eastern Kentucky University, or EKU. That's where Rick and I had our careers. He was in justice and safety, and I was in mathematics. And we also met at Eastern when we were first enrolled in college as freshmen. So that was in 1966. So that was the beginning of a beautiful relationship. And you might have noticed the field right beside our backyard. It has just been mowed. It is hay and it needs to be baled. So probably in the next week or so, that farmer will come along with a hay baler and make those round hay bales. And that will look nice and pretty and green, just like our grass that Rick has been working on. Actually, I'll have to say, we haven't had rain for 3 weeks, so this is not as lush as it generally is, but it's not doing all that bad. Now, the herbs I have over here, this is one mint plant, and it was planted about 4 years ago, maybe five, and it's in a pot to try to contain it. Mint wants to take over your whole garden, and you can see it's going up this way after those tomato plants. Rick planted 1, 2, 3, 4 large tomato plants, and they have some tomatoes on them. Lots of blooms. Here I see some tomatoes come along. These are bigger over here. Now one of his plants is a grape tomato or cherry tomato. That's this one right here. So it's going to have loads of blooms at any one particular point. And I see actually down here we have several tomatoes coming off of one point. So that's going to be interesting to watch that grow. And over here I see a fairly large tomato in there. I'm sure you can't see it, but they're just kind of hanging very nicely. And two more up here. So he did all of the work of digging out the grass, working up the soil, planting those and putting them in cages. And then our key to keeping things taken care of is putting down mulch, a material like this that keeps the weeds down and also keeps the moisture in. So we can go a few weeks without rain and still have a decent garden. And I think that's about all I have of interest. Can you think of anything, Rick?
Nope.
I covered it all. Okay, this is our update on June the 9th, and if anything dramatic happens with the herb garden, like we get a ripe tomato or something, I might come out here and give you further updates during the summer. See you later.